Hello everyone, and welcome to my second episode in my Forest Schools film series. Today, I'll be exploring my own experiences as a learner in nature, being someone who is very dyslexic and struggles to stay still. The British Dyslexia Association in 2010 defined dyslexia as a learning difficulty that primarily affects fluent word reading and spelling. However, it is much more complex than that. It affects every part of my life, from my organisational skills to remembering the simplest things, like people's names, or the basic tasks, like drinking water and tidying. I was diagnosed at a young age, as my father and all of my siblings are also dyslexic. However, it affects everyone differently. Yes, we all might struggle with spelling and reading, but it is a spectrum. The BDA also say that it is best thought about as a continuum and not a distinct scale. Now onto my own personal experiences into the outdoor world. I've always struggled to be in a classroom, but as a child being outside was my favourite. However, learning things in the outdoors was still very challenging and still very hard for me. Normal ways of teaching don't work. I need physical and practical styles of teaching, like being shown how to make a fire. This is probably the best thing I have ever been taught, as there are so many ways to do it and lots of different factors involved. Being able to run around and discover things in a wooded area helped me find ways of learning that I liked best, like pattern-related tasks, like lighting fires, building, crafting things like dens or whittling spoons. The University of Michigan say that people with dyslexia don't think in a straight line like neurotypical people do, going from one problem to another. However, we jump around and flow through problems at hyperspeed, meaning we are very good at problem solving. With my own experiences in forest school sessions, we were given a creative task to do something with some string and some sticks. While everyone had made something easy and not too challenging like a picture frame, I decided to make a basket. I had never made one before and just seen a video a couple of years ago of someone doing something similar. While everyone had finished their tasks, I had become completely absorbed in mine and needed to finish it by the end of the session, without feeling like I needed to move on to do another task. However, this does mean if someone is slow and mundane in the way that they are teaching, even in an outdoor setting, I can still get distracted and lose track, as I find it hard to focus on one thing at a time, unless it is a puzzle-like problem or very energetic and hyperactive activity, which lets me think out loud and use trial and error in a comfortable and controlled way. Forest schools really helps people like me understand how their brain works and how they see the world. I feel that the freedom of these sessions and allowing me to understand my brain works in other ways is really helpful. Being allowed to just sit there and do my own thing instead of being forced to work at someone else's pace really helps keeping me engaged and enjoying the activity. However, this is not the same for every dyslexic. Like I said before, we are all different and we all think differently, but I hope this has helped someone understand a fellow dyslexic and the ways they might learn. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. See you in the next one.